Two devices, same model name, and a maze of files on HuggingFace. Q80, Q6K, Q5KM, Q4KM, QPTQ, AWQ. One choice can save you a weekend, the other one can waste it. Today we end the guessing. By the end of this video, you'll know which file to download for your setup and use case. We'll keep it practical. A simple format map, a memory ladder you can feel in real tasks, and a file tab decoder that turns alphabet soup into a single confident click. Open models ship in multiple formats and quant levels because you trade memory for fidelity. Fewer bits per weight means smaller files and faster loads. Push it too far and you'll feel it. First as subtle reasoning slips or messy JSON, then as broken chains and brittle code. Our goal is not theory, it's choosing the right compression line for what you actually do. Quick terminology check. GGUF is basically the de facto local standard for tools like Ollama and LM Studio. MP3 like in Spirit for local AI. If you use Ollama or LM Studio, you live in GGUF. That's the download and go lane for most local users. If you live in PyTorch, XLlama, VLLM, you'll usually pick GPTQ, EXL2 or AWQ versions of the same model. GPTQ and AWQ are different compression methods, same idea of making models smaller, just different approaches that work better with certain GPU setups and Python frameworks. Same quality versus size logic, different loaders and file names. And if you need a tiny footprint without the usual forbit hit, remember QAT, quantization aware training. QAT trains the model to behave well at low bit width from the start. It's built to keep BF16-like behavior at small sizes, especially with Gemma-3 QAT. That's all the tooling we need today. No kernel rabbit holes. Think of this as a ladder where each step down saves you memory but costs you a bit of quality. At the top, Q80 feels almost identical to the full precision model. When you're chatting or coding, you honestly won't notice the difference. Step down to Q6K and you're still in the comfort zone. The model follows instructions reliably, handles structured outputs cleanly, and your code generation stays solid. Q5KM is where most people should probably land. It's that sweet spot. You'll notice a small drop in quality if you're really paying attention, but for everyday use, it's an excellent all-rounder that saves meaningful memory without breaking your workflow. Now, Q4KM is where the trade-offs become real. Great for casual chat and quick summaries, but this is where you'll start seeing the cracks. Logic slips in longer conversations, JSON outputs that drift off spec, those annoying off-by-one errors in code. Still usable, but be aware. Q3 and below only if you absolutely must squeeze. Quality falls off fast. Two quick realities to make that concrete. Structured outputs. At QKM, the model can sound confident, yet wander off schema. Invented enums sloppy braces. QKM often stabilizes that. Q6 to Q8 is where strict JSON and tool calls feel solid. Reasoning chains. Multi-hop reasoning is the first thing to suffer at Q4. Q5 is usually fine day to day. Q6 to Q8 brings nuance back and reduces dead ends. Q5KM default, Q4KM if space, Q6 or Q8 for long context. File size is not equal runtime memory. Allow some headroom. If reliability matters, bias one rung up rather than down. As a reference point, a llama 3.1 8B Q80 GGUF is around 8.5 GB. Q6K is around 6.6 GB. If that just simplified your choices, hit like, it helps others find practical guides instead of theory dumps. There's one trap almost everyone hits, on the Files tab, and it quietly wrecks results. As we open that page, watch for it. I'll call it out. Let's keep attention on one flagship family so we don't split the room. Llama 3.1 instruct. Open the Files tab and you'll see a spread from Q4 to Q8 plus full precision variants. Alright, you're looking at the Files tab and there are like 25 options. Here's how to navigate without losing your mind. First decision, how much quality can you sacrifice for memory? If you need rock solid reasoning and clean structured outputs, start your search around Q6K or Q5KM. If you're mostly just chatting and memory is tight, Q4KM will do the job. Next, look for the K versions. QKM instead of just Q4O. The K ones are newer and generally better at preserving quality. The old numbering system still works, but K ones are where the smart money is. That trap I flagged? Picking a base checkpoint for chat instead of an instruct build. Make sure you grab the instruct versions for chat applications. The base models are trained differently and won't give you that back and forth conversation experience you're expecting. In GGUF, the chat template is typically baked in. For Ollama LM Studio, pick the instruct checkpoint so the conversation format just works. Context length is how much text the model can remember in a single conversation. Think of it like short-term memory. 8k tokens is decent for most chats. 32k plus is where you can paste entire documents and have meaningful discussions about them. If long context matters, bias toward Q6 or Q8. Or use a QAT 4-bit when you need compression without the usual losses. Llama 3.1 supports up to 128k per meter. License sanity check. If you build anything commercial, verify permissions before you download. GPTQ, EXL2, if you're in PyTorch or XLlama, map Q4KM is a safe default to a 4-bit GPTQ or EXL2 setup with a similar effective bits per weight. Same trade-offs, different loader. AWQ, popular in the Transformers VLLM world. File sizes look similar to the other 4-bit variants. The difference is how quantization error shows up across tasks. If you're already here, you know why. If you keep thinking I want 4 bits without a 4-bit hit, QAT is your exit ramp. Gemma 3 QAT checkpoints are trained to preserve BF16-like behavior at tiny footprints. They're particularly good when you need long context and strict structured outputs to behave. If you try only one 4-bit variant this month and you care about fidelity, try a Gemma 3 QAT build. OpenAI's GPT-OSS models now live in the same aisle as Llama and Gemma on HuggingFace. You'll see official open weight releases, 120B and 20B, plus community conversations. Here's the twist. These are a mixture of experts models, so the 4-bit versions aren't dramatically smaller than you'd expect. The experts get quantized individually. If you're experimenting locally with GPT-OSS20B, don't automatically reach for Q4KM just because it sounds smaller. Check the actual file sizes first. You might find Q6K or even Q8O fits in nearly the same footprint with much better quality. Same file selection logic, just verify the numbers before you assume. QAT becomes the new normal. Right now, QAT is the special case that lets 4-bit behave like BF16 on tasks that usually break low-bit models. Structured outputs, long context, and multi-step reasoning. Expect more families to ship first-party QAT variants so you're not stuck choosing between tiny memory and stable behavior. KV compression is the real unlock for long context. Weights are already cheap to shrink. The KV cache is the new cost center. What's coming is better cache formats that keep accuracy high enough for 64K to 124K windows. plus smarter kernels that actually deliver speed with compressed caches. The practical result is long context without absurd memory and fewer regressions when you compress aggressively. Microsoft's push, better compression and kernels. Beyond info everywhere, the focus is shifting to smarter precision mixes and kernels that keep GPUs busy during long sequences. Translation for you, snappier long context inference and fewer quality drops when you choose smaller files. These improvements show up inside toolchains, not just in papers, so you'll feel them without changing your workflow. Native low bit models are becoming real. BitNet. Instead of compressing after training, these models are trained to work with just 3 possible values per parameter from the start. Microsoft now has working inference tools and actual models you can download. It won't replace your 70B tomorrow, but it's a credible direction toward tiny models that don't feel crippled. Format reality, GGUF remains the local default. GPU stacks keep GPTQ, AWQ, EXL2 healthy. For consumer apps, Ollama, LM Studio, llama.cpp, GGUF stays the zero drama standard. In server land, GPTQ, AWQ, EXL2 will continue to evolve. From a user's perspective, this means less fragmentation and better defaults over time. Bottom line for you, the decisions in this video age well. Default to GGUF, Q5KM, move up to Q6 or Q8 for long context or strict JSON tool use, and pick QAT when you need small memory without the usual losses. Under the hood, kernels and cache formats keep getting smarter, so the penalty for smaller files continues to shrink. Tell me which quant you picked and what you're using it for. Chat, coding, reg, long context. I'll pull the most common patterns and share what people landed on. If this decoded the file step for you, consider subscribing so you can find it later.